Sioux Falls, South Dakota is named after Sioux Falls waterfalls. So we'll see you when we get there.
Sioux Falls Park is the city's number one attraction. It is about 128 acres just north of downtown along the Big Sioux River, which flows an average of 7,400 gallons of water that drops 100 feet over the course of the falls every second. This shows where an extremely large set of pipes channeled the river's power to the turbine house. If you look close, you can make out where that pipe entered the building. The park includes the remains of the Queen Bee Mill on the east side of the river. It opened in October 1881. The seven-story main structure was built of native Sioux quartz and could process 1,500 bushels of wheat each day. Nothing like taking a break for a falls sit-down to appreciate the roar of the water behind us, and it's not a bad place for a selfie. Goose. Well, maybe gooses. Geese? Well, you get it. Noisy beggars. There is even a five-story observation tower that gives you a stunning waterside view as well as a glimpse of downtown. It is also home to the Visitors Information Center. In case you like fresh produce, eggs, meat, poultry, plants, flowers, baked goods and herbs, the Falls Park Farmers Market is open from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. every Saturday starting May through October. Of course, we weren't here on a Saturday. For a more detailed guide, go online to Experience Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Here's a close-up of the backside of the turbine house. We have been told that at night, the falls are lit with an assortment of multicolored floodlights to provide a surreal photo experience. Right on the water's edge is the old Light and Power Company building, now the Falls Overlook Café, which serves a variety of family-friendly foods, ice cream, treats, and beverages. The old horse barn now houses the Stockyards Ag Experience and provides a gateway in their parking lot for a $2 trolley tour of downtown. Shelly seems to have found a tractor trailer she's pretty comfortable with. This trolley is only $2 for adults, and small kids seem to ride for free. The driver is quite knowledgeable and gives a good Reader's Digest condensed version of downtown points of interest. We were planning to stay and see some of the night lights, but sadly needed to get back to the park to ready for our travel day. The next morning we broke camp, a nice spot, KOA, with 50 amps and water, just no sewer. We spent 3 nights here and then used the convenient dump station on our way out of the park. A short 95-mile or so drive to our next destination, where we'll be parked for about a week, and we'll include a flight back to the Phoenix Valley for a few doctor's appointments. Let's hope that there aren't any issues like the last time we did this. See the link to the attached episode here. Thanks again, guys. We just can't say enough about how you're helping the channel to grow. So far, those who have been and those who have just hopped on for the ride, we love you all. Please, travel safe. We'll leave you with some aerial views of our new campsite. Watch for some little blurs diving past the drone. Those are swallows dive bombing it.
What is the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow?
What do you mean? An African or European swallow?
Huh? I don't know that.